In this video, I want to show how we can add back pressure and bulkheads to our Java Enterprise applications using MicroProfile fault tolerance. In the past, I already recorded a similar video how to do that using Adam Bean's Porcupine library and plain Java EE. And now with MicroProfile fault tolerance 2.0, this is also very simple and doable by using MicroProfile only. So for that, I want to show you an example application that is called Instruments Craft Shop, and that I enhanced now with this MicroProfile example. And let's quickly walk through the code here. So how that works is that we use asynchronous JAXRS resources, similar like in the last content, that now will return a completion stage of what we want to return in this method here. So that tells the JAXRS implementation to not use the default request thread pool, but to use the thread pool that is provided by this type internally. And the nice story, what we can use is that our bean can also return a completion stage here if we use fault tolerance and annotate that method with bulkhead and asynchronous annotations. So bulkhead defines this method to be a bulkhead, depending on the type, either a semaphore type or a thread pool, a bulkhead. And if we use asynchronous, then this will be a thread pool bulkhead. So now the return type completion stage is also supported since fault tolerance 2.0. And this is now very practical for us since we can combine that easily with asynchronous JAXRS resources. And then what we do, we specify the value, that means the size of the thread pool and the waiting queue on this annotation, and therefore configure it. What is also important to mention is that we need to define a proper and reasonable scope here. So we use the application scope annotation, because otherwise that would not make sense if we, for example, would use an implicit dependent or request scope on that bean, because then implicitly we would always create a new implicit thread pool, which somewhat would defeat the purpose. So therefore we define this bean to be application scoped, and then we use these implicit bulkhead thread pools. Then similarly, to apply back pressure to notify our client that this application is currently under heavy load, we use a JAXRS exception mapper to actually map this exception that will then occur, default tolerance bulkhead exception, to the appropriate status code for HTTP 503 service unavailable, for example. So that will be returned to the client immediately once the application is not able to fully handle that request, because then the bulkhead will be full in terms of a pool size and waiting queue. So that is now similar to the contents of the last video on that topic, how to do that using fault tolerance. To show you an example how that works in a running application, that application is now up and running here, and we can use it to query the instruments, for example, to ask it to provide us the instruments. And similarly, we can also create new instruments, in both cases using the JAXRS resources that now uses these two bulkheads individually, respectively. What we can also do is that we continuously ask to, well, either provide us the instrument or create new instruments. And here we see in the left and right window that we use these two JAXRS resources. And now to show you that we're actually using two individual bulkheads and are not using a shared thread pool, let's put the first one, one of our resources, on the lib bit of pressure. So we use Apache Bench to, well, provide some more pressure on that to include more requests. And we can see now that for most of the requests, well, if they're not lucky enough to make it in into the queue, that we actually immediately get a response of 503 service unavailable. And at the same time, the resource for creating new instruments, that uses a totally individual bulkhead, individual thread pool, that is not affected by our heavy load on the system. So let's run it again. first resource that Bulkhead will most of the time return errors, but immediately errors, not after the official artificial delay that we built into our business logic, but immediately return that the resource currently is on the heavy load. And this is how we can include MicroProfile fault tolerance into our applications. What is also very nice is that we use fault tolerance together with MicroProfile metrics. So here I included the server configuration for OpenLiberty. Then what I also showed earlier on my blog is MicroProfile fault tolerance together with metrics actually provides some default metrics for our fault tolerance resiliency patterns out of the box. So if we include that, for example, on OpenLiberty, so I have a video that shows this here, what we can do, we can use the default Prometheus output format of these metrics being provided, and then point a Grafana dashboard, for example, the default dashboard that is provided for MicroProfile, to our application and, well, see some of the metrics that are being provided here. So if we have a look at Bulkhead metrics here, for example, we can see some metrics for, well, these two individual resources, and we also can see what's happening inside our application. And since these methods are the methods are provided with auto discovery, depending on what we define in our application, we can include this technical monitoring data without, well, configuring much ourselves. So you can have a look at the example project on GitHub, how to do that. But setting up this monitoring is very straightforward. We basically just have to configure our runtime that I do using this OpenLiberty configuration here, and then point a Prometheus and Grafana instance to our running application to get these monitoring data. And this is how we not only include Bulkheads and Backpressure, but how we can also instrument what's going on inside our application using MicroProfile fault tolerance and metrics here. Thanks for watching.